So today we are going to start from preparation of alcohols. First we will see from alkenes. So for alkenes we will see the mechanism first. First step here is protonation of alkene. So for that we will need H plus, so we will get it from H2O. So H2O, and we will take here H plus, so it will form H3O plus. So this we will use for the protonation of alkene, and we will get here a carbocation. So here we know that here 2 pi electrons are present, which are free. So this H3O plus. Will attract these electrons, and here the bond will break, the bond will be cleaved, and you will get here a carbocation plus H2O. So our first step is completed. Now second step. Now nucleophilic attack of water on carbocation. So here this H2O is nucleophile and this is our carbocation. So this will attack here on the carbocation. This is carbocation, so it is electron deficient. So it will attract this electrons towards itself. And this will join here. So now this has gained the charge here, positive. Now we will do deprotonation to form an alcohol. This is our step number 3. So again this deprotonation, here we will have one more H2O. So deprotonation will take place by this. It will attract this hydrogen and we will get here alcohol. And we will get one more H3O plus. For further reaction. So from this mechanism we will see example. We will take one unsymmetrical alkene. And here from protonation the OH group will be added here. That is less substituted carbon. So we will get here alcohol. So this is secondary alcohol because 2 beta carbons are present here. So here we can see that Markovnikov rule is followed. By hydroboration oxidation, this is our second method. Here we will use B2H6. So here, as we can see its structure, we will find 2p orbitals empty. So if we take an alkene, This free pi electrons will be attracted here by this empty orbitals. So on its reaction, you will get CH3, and this hydrogen, this bond will break and this hydrogen will shift here. Further, one more time, still this orbital remains empty because it is giving its hydrogen here to this free electrons. So again we will react it with an alkene. So we will get CH3, CH2, CH2 twice, BH. So here you can see one more hydrogen it has given here and it became CH2. Still this orbital remains empty, so one more time we will react it with alkene. Now this electrons has entered this orbital and you are getting here 3 units of alkene with boron. Now we will add H2O. So here 3 units of boron are present and 3 units of alkene are present. So we will add 3H2O2. And you will get here alcohol. Plus BOH thrice. So you can see here you have got primary alcohol. Only alpha carbon is present. And here you can see that anti-Markovnikov rule is followed. Why? Because OH group is attached to the carbon which was more substituted. Here CH2 is more substituted than CH. So you can see that here anti-Markovnikov rule is followed. Now second method is from carbonyl compounds. So here first it is by reduction of aldehyde and ketones. So here we will take one example of aldehyde. Now you know that for reduction we need a catalyst, so here we will take catalyst as palladium. So you will get your RCH2OH. And for ketone, catalyst used is NaBH4, and you will get your alcohol. You can see here that in aldehyde the yield is primary alcohol, and for ketone the yield is secondary alcohol. Now second method is by reduction of carboxylic acid. Esters. So here we will take general carboxylic acid, and the catalyst used here is a highly reducing agent, that is lithium aluminium hydride in presence of H2O, you will get alcohol. Now we will see here that mechanism. So this hydrogen and this OH will be removed as H2O and you will get RCOR-. Now on catalytic reduction you will get alcohol. Our third method is from Grignard reagent. So we all know that Grignard reagent means RMgX. So you know that here this is partially positive and this is partially negative. So on reaction with Grignard reagent, here this pi electrons will shift on oxygen. So this will develop partial negative charge and here partial positive. So this is partially negative and this is partially positive. So this R will join here and MgX will join here. So ultimately you will get here an intermediate which is like this, which is also known as adduct. Now on addition of H2O, you know that H2O, I will divide it here as H plus and OH minus. So on this cleavage of this bond, this H plus will go to this oxygen. Why? Because this is partially negative and MgX will remain partially positive. So this OH part will join to Mg and they will separate as alcohol. This H has joined to oxygen, so you have got here as alcohol and the OH part has joined with Mg. So you have got here MgOHX. Now we will see that with aldehyde, reaction with Grignard reagent. On addition of H2O, you will get primary alcohol. And on reaction with ketone, with Grignard reagent, and on addition of H2O, you will get alcohol, that is tertiary alcohol. That's it.